We have come into this house and this is the day. We have come into his hall and gathered in his name to worship him.
We have come into his hall and gathered in his name to worship him. We have come into his hall and gathered in his name to worship Christ.
This is the day that has seen a little more life than the first one. This is the day. Everybody, this is the day. This is the day that the Lord has made. That the Lord has made, we will
rejoice, we will rejoice and be glad in, and be glad in. This is the day that the Lord has made, and we will rejoice and be glad in. This is the day.
This is when the Spirit You are our God. You are our God. You are our God. Praise your name. We will praise your name. God, we will give thanks for your faithfulness. For this is the day, this is the day that the Lord have made, that the Lord has made. We of me. We are sinful creatures. We cannot deny it or hide from it. But we can confess our sins to our God who created us. And God, who longs for us to be whole, will forgive us our sins and purify our hearts. We confess to you. Jesus Christ was given to die for the sins of all people once for all time. Because of his suffering, death, and resurrection, God accounts to us Christ's righteousness. We are forgiven and free to live in holiness by the power of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
The opening hymn, hymn 361, All People That on Earth Do Dwell, hymn 361.
Thank you.
redeeming Lord Jesus Christ, the creating love of God, and the communion of the sanctified Holy Spirit be with you all.
And also with you.
O Creator God, with your breath you created light and darkness. By your word you created the heavens. You created the dry land of the earth and the waters of the sea. By your word, you call forth growing things, plants, fruits, and trees. You created the sun and the moon to order the days and nights. You created the living creatures in the waters and the living creatures of the air. You created the living creatures of the land, cattle, and wild animals. Everything that moves upon the land. By your word, you created humankind, both female and male, to care for the earth and all that is over, on, and in it. And to these new creatures, you gave everything that you had made. The Lord be with you. O God, you have prepared for those who love you such good things as surpass our understanding. Pour into our hearts such love towards you that we, loving you in all things and above all things, may obtain your promises which exceed all that we can desire. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. We pray God to bless the industries and the commercial life of our land, especially those in the area of Belleville. Let us pray together. Almighty God, cheer our toy and hallowed our neighbor. Be present with their people where they work. And give us all a pride in what we do and a just return for our neighbor. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. We pray for our homes and families. In a moment of silence, let us pray for the homes for which we have come this morning. Lord, in your mercy, let us pray together. Heavenly Father, your Son, our Lord Jesus, please seek for the ministry of the word.
First lesson is taken from the book of Ecclesiasticus, chapter 38, beginning at the 38th verse. So it is with every artisan and master artisan who labors by night as well as by day. Those who cut the signets of seals, each is diligent in making a great variety. They set their heart on painting a lifelike image, and they are careful to finish their work. So it is with the smith sitting by the anvil, intent on his iron work. The breath of fire melts his flesh, and he struggles with the heat of the furnace. The sound of the hammer deafens his ears, and his eyes are on the pattern of the object. He sets his heart on finishing his handiwork, and he is careful to complete its decoration. So, it is with the potter sitting at his work and turning the wheel with his feet. He is always deeply concerned over his products, and he produces them in quantity. He molds the clay with his arm and makes it pliable with his feet. He sets his heart on finishing the glazing, and he takes care in firing the kiln. All these rely on their hands, and all are skillful in their own work. Without them, no city can be inhabited, and wherever they live, they will not go hungry. Yet they are not sought out for the counsel of the people. The word of the Lord. The psalm appointed for this service is Psalm 107, verses 1 to 9.
Thank you. reading from Paul's first letter to the Corinthians, chapter 3, beginning at verse 10. According to the grace of God given to me, like a skilled master builder, I laid a foundation, and someone else is building on it. Each builder must choose with care how to build on it. For no one can lay any foundation other than the one that has been laid. That foundation is Jesus Christ. Now, if anyone builds on the foundation with gold, silver, precious stones, wood, hay, straw, the work of each builder will become visible, for the day will disclose it, because it will be revealed with fire, and the fire will test what sort of work each has done. If what has been built on the foundation survives, the builder will receive a reward. The word of the Lord.
The hymn for the graduate is hymn 529, 529. Lord, the light of your love is shining.
Be with you.
And also with you.
A reading from the Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to Matthew, beginning at the 6th, the 19th verse. Do not store up for yourselves treasures on earth, where moth and rust consume, and where thieves break in and steal. But store up for yourselves treasures in heaven, where neither moth nor rust consumes, and where thieves do not break in and steal. For where your treasure is, there your heart will be also. The eye is the lamp of the body. So if your eye is healthy, your whole body will be full of light. But if your eye is unhealthy, your whole body will be full of darkness. If then the light in you is darkness, how great is the darkness? No one can serve two masters, for a slave will either hate the one and love the other, or be devoted to one and despise the other. You cannot serve God and wealth. The Gospel of Christ.
In the name of God, Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit, amen. Amen. Today we are St. Cyprian observe Rogation Sunday, and we thank God for industry and commerce. And in a special way, we want to celebrate the businesses that are found in Belleville and the surrounding communities, and pray that God would bless them. The first reading makes the point that the community needs various skills and talents for its existence, and it encourages us to develop our skills and to use them to the glory of God and the benefit of humankind. Business creates opportunities for meaningful work, and that is, and creativity that is essential for human dignity and a peaceful society. Entrepreneurship, wealth creation, and wise management of resources is commended in the Bible. I want to draw your attention to the following passages from Proverbs. Proverbs chapter 12, verse 11. He who takes his hand will have plenty of bread, but he who follows worthless pursuits has no sense. And Proverbs chapter 10, verse 4. A slack hand causes poverty, but the hand of diligent makes rich. The Bible has a positive view of industry and commerce. And in today's reading, from the first reading, we find that the writer makes the point that in order for a society to develop, everybody has to play a part. In our societies, the doctors, the nurses, the fishermen, the grave diggers, the scavengers, the maids, everybody has to be involved in some kind of productivity so that our land can prosper and develop. And so the Bible, it praises men and women, boys and girls, who use their gifts and their talents from God to make a living for themselves and to provide for their families. And when you read the Bible, it frowns on lazy people and all who squander their lives. We are familiar with the text. When we're at school, we had to learn passages from Proverbs. You too, I guess. And one was what? Go to the ant, what? Consider your ways and be well. Go to the ant, thou sluggard, consider your ways and be well. Against laziness, laziness. And looking at this congregation this morning, I don't see any lazy faces here in front of me. Everybody look industrious and they work with their hands. And the Bible says that we have to make the best use of our lives. It says, be creative, be productive. Use every God-given gift and opportunity to develop ourselves. And as we develop ourselves, we made a meaningful contribution to Barbados. All of you at Mass this morning, as you work and toil day and night, you are contributing in some way to the development of our nation. And everybody has that responsibility. This is where laziness is a curse. A curse. And we, as Christians, as we keep Rogation Sunday with an emphasis on industry and commerce, we must refrain from giving the impression that business is bad. You know, without business, our nation will die. And we need to encourage all persons to get involved in some kind of business activity. Part of this, I believe, is to encourage persons, where possible, to be self-employed and to take pride in what we do and to take that leap of faith. And by taking that leap of faith and entering into the business life of our nation, there's always the possibility that we'll be successful and that growth will come. And therefore, we must not be afraid to enter into the unknown of business with the belief that God will guide us. Business people expect a just return on their investment. We cannot and should not condemn business people for making money on their investment. If you invest, you want to make a profit. Is that so? Otherwise, it won't serve any purpose. There'd be no purpose. However, it cannot be profit at any cost. It cannot be profit
at any cost. We must be honest. We must be just, fair, and righteous. But more than that, we who are involved in any kind of business, the profit lane is not the only criterion to use. It must always have the good of the society at heart. If the emphasis is just to make money without thinking about the good of the society and the community, it is naked selfishness. And has no part in our community as we seek to be one. And profit, which comes because of exploitation of workers, the compromise of human dignity, and the jettison of workers' rights, is evil, immoral, reprehensible, and it has no place in a modern Barbados. We cannot encourage exploitation in our commercial life in our land. The Bible says, set not your heart on riches. If your riches increase, do not set your heart upon them. I think what the Bible is saying to all of us, especially those in business as we celebrate it today, do not worship your profit. Do not make it your God. I think it asks us to strike a balance. And as we engage in business, it asks us to remember that each person is made in the image and the likeness of God. And at no time should we destroy the image of God, which is found in every man and woman, in the name of making a profit. Sad to say, it seems that this principle is not always observed. One hears of many stories of workers are treated by employers. And any business or commercial activity that has no regard for the rights of people, that does not respect the dignity of every man or woman, ought to be condemned in no uncertain terms. And at the same time, we who are employees, we have a responsibility to give of our best. It's a two-way stream. So very often, we emphasize the obligation of the employer, and we forget that the employees, they too have obligation to work. From a biblical perspective, business is laudable when it promotes justice, honesty, generosity, love for the neighbor, when it responds to human need and suffering. And so to this end, all of us or anyone who engages in any kind of business or commercial activity, we have an obligation to respond to the needs of the communities that surround us, and to promote peace and goodwill. To promote peace and goodwill. The point is, our business people must have compassion in their relationships and respond however we can to human need and suffering that exists in nations wherever you go. And also, I think, on this day, I think I need to draw your attention that the writer of Genesis in that story, he has no doubt that people are to work for a living by the sweat of your brow, what? You shall eat bread. By the sweat of your brow, you shall eat bread. You see, you may not realize it, but work is an extension of who we are and what we can be. Work is an extension of you. What you are and what you can be. And people who refuse to work, not those who want to work but cannot get work, but those who refuse to work purposely are parasites and a drain on the society. And Paul writes, those who do not work should not eat. Some of the parents should listen to Paul again. Those who do not work should not eat. Not those who cannot get work, but those who will not work. And since work is an extension of the individual, unemployment is a social evil. It denies people to be creative and innovative. It robs people of their creative skills, and the society is the poorer. We as a church, we as a community, NGOs and government, we need to ensure that our businesses thrive and are successful so that people can find gainful employment. And without employment, people cannot provide for their basic needs, and this robs them of their human dignity and identity. And so government and the private sector must come together and do all that they can to make it possible for people to find jobs. And one of the sad things about the present time is that there are so many persons in our land who are frustrated because they cannot find a job. Maybe this contributes to some of the social difficulties we have, maybe. And so on this Rogation Sunday, we pray God to bless our land. We pray God that those who lead us in business and commerce, that they will be honest in their work, and that they may treat their workers with respect. And we pray that employees will also be honest in their work. And we pray this morning for many people, especially our young men and young women who are unable to find work and provide for themselves. And to those of you in this congregation who might be involved in any kind of business activity, public or private, I invite you to be good business people and to bring Christian principles in all the decisions that you make in your respective fields of endeavor. Do all you can as Christian business leaders to help our people develop themselves and provide for their families. And finally, let us all pool our resources together as we work for the common good, and let us make a promise that we will not exploit anyone. May God bless Barbados, and may God bless the various businesses that are found in Belleville and the surrounding communities. Amen. Shall we stand? In one God, with the Father and the Son, is worshipped and glorified. The intercession, you may sit or kneel. And the intercession can be followed on the monitors with the responses.
This morning, our intercession follows. Our intercessions, prayers of the church. Lord God, we pray for your church throughout the world. May there be a harvest of freedom, places where your spirit moves in and through us, your people, that we might all that we call us to be. Lord, hear us. Eternal Lord God, to whom belong all power and dominion, we seek the guidance of your Spirit for all on whom is laid the responsibility of government. We pray for Sandra, our president, mayor or prime minister, members of parliament, and all others in authority in our land, that they may have wisdom to order the affairs of our nation in accordance with your will. Especially, we pray for those wrestling with the economic difficulties we currently face, that through their endeavors, they may be created a just and loving society to which all may feel they belong. Lord, hear us. Almighty God, from whom all good gifts come, grant to those who hold office in our country the spirit of justice and truth, of wisdom and charity, that, mindful of their responsibility and the needs of those they serve, they may promote the true welfare of all our people. May they have skills in dealing with the often conflicting demands made on them, and wisdom in allocating the limited resources at their disposal. May they at all times give protection and help to those in special need. Lord, hear us. O God, our Father, as we acknowledge our dependence on your bounty for our daily food, so we also seek your blessing on those engaged in agriculture. We pray that you will so prosper their work that the earth may yield to us its full harvest. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
We pray too, Lord, for all who work in industry and commerce. We thank you for creating women and men in your own image, giving them the ability to turn raw material into objects of use and beauty. May they not forget their indebtedness to you, nor that their creative efforts are performed to your honor, the enrichment of humankind, and the benefit of the earth. Lord, hear us. In you, Lord, are hidden all the treasures of wisdom and knowledge. We pray for all engaged in the work of education and training. Bless the work of our universities, colleges, schools, and training institutions, that in them your name may be honored, and for them may come men, and from them may come men and women and young people who seek and love the truth as it is revealed in your Son, Jesus Christ. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
We thank you, O God, for all who work in the social services, caring professions, and in voluntary work. May they combine sympathy with firmness and love with understanding. Uphold them when they grow weary. Guard them from despair when human problems seem intractable, and renew them daily in your love. Lord, hear us.
Lord, gracious hear us.
Father, we pray for the casualties of our economic life, for those whose work is monotonous or stressful, for the low paid and those struggling to make ends meet, for the unemployed and those threatened with redundancy, for failed businesses and all victims of any kind of recession, for those in debt, those who are ill, those who are homeless, and for those who are anxious or in despair. May we all work together to strengthen the weak and empower the powerless. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
Almighty God and Father, you have so ordered our life together. Almighty God and Father, we have so ordered our life that we are dependent on one another. Prosper those engaged in commerce and industry, and direct their minds and hands that they may rightly use your gifts in the service of others. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen.
Give you
sin, we deceive ourselves, and the truth is not in us. If we confess our sins, God is faithful and just, and we forgive our sins and cleanse us from all unrighteousness. Let us now confess our sins. Almighty God, in thought, Almighty God, have mercy upon you, pardon and all your sins. Confirm and strengthen your goodness, keep your life eternal through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Please stand. We are the body of Christ, by the one Spirit, we are all baptized into one body and have all been made to drink of the one Spirit. The peace of the Lord be always with you. Please sit. The notice says this morning, you find them all in the parish letter, all the notices for this week. I won't go through all of them to save time. We are running a bit, not too late, but people want to get back home and go to lunch. And just on page 3, this week, Thursday, is Ascension Day. So there's no Mass on Wednesday morning, but the Mass is on Thursday, Ascension Day. We ask people to volunteer for the summer vacation Bible class, which will begin in July, and we want you to come and assist in it. You can speak to one of us and tell us. We want to resume our Sunday school on June the 11th, and on June the 5th, at past 5, I'm inviting all those persons who will be interested in assisting in the Sunday school to meet with me on June the 5th in the parish hall. We are making plans to provide some training sessions for persons to do floral arranging in the parish. At the moment, 7 persons have indicated their interest in it. So we are glad for that response of about 7 persons to assist with us. But if we can get some more, we will be happier also. The sacrament to the sick is on May the 18th and the 24th. May the 17th is World Hypertension Day. And at the back, a short write-up about Ascension and the feast day. Birthdays in the parish. We have Davy Fitzpatrick. Davy is at the back there, Davy. Cora Holder, she's one of our shatting. Cora is one of our shattings. And then the last person, Patricia Bryan, is she at Mass today? Miss Patricia. Oh. Right, Pat's birthday is on Friday, and she will reach that Saturday, and she will reach that important age in her life. I won't tell you how old she would be, but we are the same age. I understand there's a private party for her, to which you are not invited. Anybody else has a birthday parish? Any more people have birthday at the parish? Anybody else? No, but let us say happy birthday then for these people. We want to extend a warm welcome to our visitors. All those who are visiting, we welcome you to St. Cyprian. I hope I have the names right. Jean Raytay, Jean's granddaughter. Is it Zohi Fites? Right. And we have a student with us from Cotterton. He came forward. Aster Dean, where is he? He's out there. Right, welcome to St. Cyprian. I'll be away for 2 Sundays. But I'll be back. My boyfriend and I, we are going on a vacation also. We're away for 10 days. We go to Panama, some of us. And I won't tell you what we plan to do on it. That is private and confidential. But you may see the results of it later down the road. Trust me, I don't tell lies. No. Yesterday, as you know, we dedicated this weekend to Rogation, with an emphasis on industry and commerce, and we tried to focus on the Belleville community. I think we had about 9 or 10 people that came,
we had invited lots of people to come, but most of the people in Bellevue are doctors or dentists. I think we have about 85 doctors or dentists in this area, and it's difficult for doctors to put things on display. But some people came, and I thought it was successful. And we only came up with this idea about some weeks ago. Brenda and I were talking to one or two others, and I told them, let us see how we can embrace the community. And we came up with this idea, embracing business in the Bellevue and the surrounding communities. So we want to thank you for sharing yesterday. As I said before the mass, there are some things on display that you can take one if you so desire. And I'm going to invite Brenda. I always call her my mouthpiece. And the committee's mouthpiece.
Morning, everyone. We sang, "This is the day that the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it." It's a beautiful day. And before I give thanks, I want to say happy Mother's Day to all mothers, grandmothers, aunts, uncles, the fathers who played the role of father and mother. We have some of those, quite a lot of those in Barbados. And I hope you have a beautiful and a wonderful day. Now, as Canon said, yesterday we had a really, really nice event. As you can see right along here, we had the exhibitors, the companies. We had 8 companies that participated. Chem Screen Laboratory Services, which was represented by Dr. Boyce. She gave a thorough list of all the services which they provide, and she has left some brochures over there on the piano. Just take them before you leave. The Heart and Stroke Foundation, represented by Valerie Allen, she did BP checks, and the Body Mass Index. That's the first time I ever did a Body Mass Index in my life. Yeah, it was like, oh, okay. I'm slightly obese. The Diabetes Association, represented by Dr. Smith and one of our members, they did the blood pressure checks, the cholesterol and sugar. The Girls Industrial Union, represented by Merlene Phipps and Corrine, they displayed the beautiful craft work, which is produced by members, and Corrine is there with the displays. And by the way, they're celebrating 111 years of service. The National Council for Substance Abuse, she spoke with us about the use of non-use of alcohol and the negative impact which we can have on our health if we don't manage it carefully, and we know that. And then we have National Insurance. Mr. Strickland was really busy. We have the banner there, and the books are there for those of you who are still in business. You can take one before you leave. Please take those before you leave. He's recommended that we should do a lecture at the church on NIS and its contributions. And with the canon's permission, I will arrange that. I think it is very, very important. We only think about NIS when we get sick and when we retire. And we want to know how much money we are going to get. And I say to everybody, your pension cannot support you. It is a third of what you earn. It works out to be that. So young people, I'm not talking to the old and the young people, you need to make plans. Save $20 a week. You can do that. He's shaking his head. Or make it 10 then. Put down $10 and you'll be surprised when you get an age how much money you have. And we had the QVO Medical Center, represented by Drs. Nakisha Stevenson and Andrea Braffitt. They spoke with the ladies about the gynecological problems, and other health issues. And then we had Sagico, represented by Dwight and his colleague, told us all about investments, life and health insurance, retirement plans, etc. It was really, really a good afternoon. We didn't have a huge crowd,
but we had enough people that we were busy, and at 5 o'clock, nobody was really interested in leaving, right? I want to thank all the companies. We are going to send out the thank you letters to them, and the visitors, members of the congregation who participated, also to the committee and all the members when we delivered all these letters, and to Mrs. Isaacs for helping us write up those letters, and Corrine. The session yesterday was very informative. There is a lot to know about yourself, and it was an enjoyable afternoon. And quite frankly, Canon, I would do it again.
Yeah.
It was very pleasant. So now that we have formed relationships with the business communities, we would like to include them in whatever activity we will be having here. Now, speaking about activities, our next event will be on Sunday, July the 30th. Take out your cell phones and put these save the dates in them. Sunday, July the 30th is going to be the celebration of our Crop Over Thanksgiving Sunday. And persons are being encouraged to dress in your crop over colors and bring whatever you make or grow and sell them after the service. So if you growing lettuce in your backyard or produce, you have something, whatever you're growing, you can bring them and sell them. We are also asking, people can also make local drinks, and the fish cakes will be on sale. And the big one everybody has been asking me, Brenda, when is our fellowship day? Sunday the 27th of August. Sunday the 27th of August will be our fellowship day at King George V Park. We can't go near the beaches because, you know, we have the sargassum seaweed to deal with, and there is a stench and flies. We don't want to do that. And you will hear about more of that next month. And before I go, Canon, can I use this forum? We were talking about jobs and having jobs and what that, getting. Right now, one of my organizations, we have 10 vacancies. And I cannot find people.
What are you doing?
I need a floor manager, 2 cashiers, 2 merchandisers, a push-up boy, and a general worker. Yes, I'm getting applications, but it's from 18-year-olds. Hey, let's get real, okay? Sorry? I'm saying that we are employing anybody who is eligible. Yes, Val, including the old people. So when we say one thing, we have to say another. Hiring people in this country is extremely difficult. The older people are not leaving their jobs. And the younger ones, they're coming in, they're staying for a week and they're leaving. I had a girl last week, she worked for a day. It is a serious, serious problem. And we talk about people are not finding work. But when you find the people, they do not want to work. They think it is easy work. So when you come into work and you see a long line of people in front of you at a cash register, young lady, suck your teeth and go along home. This is not for me. And it is very, very time consuming. I've said all of that to say this. Anybody in here who has anybody who's looking for a job, see me after work, after church, okay? I'm always in the working mode, right? So that being said, have a great Mother's Day, and I'll talk to some of you after. Thank you very much.
We're late.
The offertory hymn 360, 360, All Creatures of Our God and King. Hymn 360.
Thank you.
Let us say together, Father, we offer you these gifts which you have given us.
This bread, this wine, this money, if then we offer ourselves, our lives, and our work to become through your Holy Spirit
a reasonable,
holy, and lovely sacrifice. As this bread and wine become the body and blood of Christ,
so may we.
So may we and all your people become channels of your love through the same Christ our Lord. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
Also with you.
Lift up your heart.
Lift them up to God.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give our thanks and praise.
It is right and a good and joyful thing, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Father Almighty, everlasting God. But chiefly are we bound to praise you for the glorious resurrection of your Son Jesus Christ, our Lord. For he is the true Paschal Lamb who was sacrificed for us and has taken away the sin of the world. By his death, he has destroyed death. And by his rising to life again, he has won for us eternal life. Therefore, we praise you, joining our voices with angels and artists before the company of heaven, who forever sing this hymn to proclaim the glory of your name. Holy,
holy, holy Lord, Lord of power and light, heaven and earth are full of your glory, who is the honor of the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord, who is thine in the highest.
We continue with form B, form B. Holy and gracious Father, all creation rightly gives you praise. All life, all holiness comes from you through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord, whom he sent to share our human nature, to live and die as one of us, to reconcile us to you, the God and Father of all. We therefore bring you these gifts. We ask you to make them holy by the power of your Spirit, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, of his Savior, Jesus Christ, who offered himself in obedience to your will, the perfect sacrifice for all mankind. On the night he was betrayed, he took bread, and when he had given thanks to you, he broke it, gave it to the disciples, and said, "Take this and eat it. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." And after supper, he took the cup of wine. When he had given thanks, he gave it to them and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this whenever you drink it for the remembrance of me." Let us therefore proclaim the mystery of our faith. Christ has died.
Christ is risen. Christ may come again.
So, Father, calling to mind the death of your Son in joy for our salvation, his glorious resurrection and ascension, his continued intercession for us, 11. And looking for his coming again in glory, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and life-giving sacrifice. Look with favor on your church's offering
and grant that we who eat and drink these holy gifts may be favored with your Holy Spirit and become one body in Christ and serve you in unity, constancy, and peace. May you make us a perpetual offering to you and have us in communion with Blessed Mary, St. Cyprian, our patron saint, and the whole company of heaven to share in the inheritance of your saints. With him and in him and through him, by the power of the Holy Spirit, we worship you, Father Almighty, with all who stand before you in earth and heaven, in songs of everlasting praise. Blessing and honor and glory and power
be yours forever and ever. Amen.
As our Savior has taught us, so we pray, our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name, your kingdom come.
Your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial and deliver us from evil.
For the kingdom, the power, God of promise, you have prepared a banquet for us.
Happy are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lamb of God,
you've taken away the sin of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you've taken away the sin of the world, have mercy on us.
Lamb of God,
you've taken away the sin of the world, grant us peace.
The gifts of God for the people of God.
Our
souls will feast and be satisfied.
Thank you.
First Communion hymn, hymn 625, We Come as Guests Invited, hymn 625.
Thank you. Yeah. Lord, prepare me.
Lord, prepare me to be a sanctuary, pure and holy, tried and true, with thanksgiving. I'll be a
the Lord be with you.
I'm also with you.
This is the day that the Lord has made.
Let us rejoice and be glad in it.
Let us pray together. Almighty Father, we thank you for feeding us
with the body and blood of your Son, Jesus Christ. May we share his body, live his risen life. We will despise, bring life to others. We upon whom your spirit shines, give light to the world. Help us to continue a faithful witness to your word. So we and all your children shall be free. And the whole earth with the praise of your name. Through Jesus. Amen.
The blessing. The God of peace, who brought again from the dead our Lord Jesus, the great shepherd of the sheep, make you perfect in every good work to do his will. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be with you and your loved ones this day and always. I just want to welcome back Douglas Braffy. He was in hospital last week, and he's back with us at Mass this morning. And also nice to see Mrs. Phyllis Eswick with us at Mass this morning. Also nice to see her son Rafael. I'm not sure how to describe him. a visitor or welcoming member. But nice to see you this morning also. Before the final hymn now, the ladies are going to distribute carnations to the women at church. The ladies will distribute the carnations to the women at church. Now, you are invited to come up in single file, and the ladies who are sitting and are unable to come up, the little ones will bring you your carnation, those who are unable to come up. And then the mothers present, women who are biological and not biological mothers, you can't come up. The women can't come up in single file.
We have a few extra carnations. If you would like one to take to your mom or somebody, so just come if you want an extra one. Look. Please stand. Next Sunday morning at the Mass, we have an address by Mr. George Griffith. He will speak on the care of the elderly. The Lord be with you. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
The hymn is Standing on the Promises. Standing on the Promises.